when I was in Dibrugarh jail, the result was announced and I got first prize for that. And I was not allowed to take the prize. My mother received it. Suddenly, overnight, I become a novelist. And novelist, who is in jail? I'm very young, 20 years old. Electronic media, still people gave me and it was, you know, big success. Then there was a challenge when someone, you know, to say that in this young age that you have got so much, you know, appreciation and this is sometime, you know, goes to your head, you may not create a game, it will be difficult. I went to that JB College. They gave me a standing ovation. It was very, you know, it can, you know, get it from my, I can, it could have been arrogant, it can, you know, that it might have destroyed my, you know, creative, but at, that art, I become a big writer. Then someone told me that, you know, some professor of Delhi College, now your challenge is to write a second novel. It is very difficult after becoming famous for a novel and to write the second one. I don't know, it's so easy. I wrote, so it was fine. But really for 10 years, almost 10 years, I could not write. I wrote only one novel when I studied in Guwahati University. It was a thing about Assamese. And it was, and by this time, I had started knowing all these, you know, realities because I was growing and I went to Guwahati. I was studying at Guwahati Cotton College and Guwahati University. I saw what is actually happening at that time. And I was a little, you know, sad and I didn't know what to do. So I wrote a novel. It was a big failure. Then it was a period of confusion, a period of class, a period of, you know, indecision, and I was barren for 9 years. So it's a difficult period for me, and I had to decide where to go. What should I do? Then I don't want to discuss about all this. I want to just tell you the journey. I decided that actually what, that because my husband was a minister, there is a proposal, and I was an activist, there was a proposal, many times they have proposed me to join politics. But I thought that I don't want this power thing. People respect in front of me and they, you know, say all bad things behind. I didn't want that thing. Because I saw the love of the people. So I knew clearly that I didn't want that. So I decided not to join politics. But what to do? I did my MA. I joined Difficult Government College, a lecturer of political science. But still that period was a confusing period still. I tried my best to write, but I could not write. Anything, maybe a few poems, but not any novel or any sorcery I don't write. I have written a few only, and I'm not good at that. Then one day I realized that what I want in this life. I decided, and I realized that I want to go back to those days. Means the love of to go to those people who loved me. And now they are looking at a minister's wife, you know, with anger, with frustration, with jealousy, or so many things. I wanted those love again. I want that back. I want to be like, just like what I did in time, during Assam movement, that is activists that work for the betterment of the society or for my country, So that is the, you know, my goal. And I found that that is a goodness at the core. There's purity, innocence, there is love, there is honesty, there is that commitment. Everything I found at that, in that core. And I decided to create a path because there is no path open for me, because it is difficult that when you get the identity of a politician, minister's wife, good people generally, you know, there is a general, you know, generally they don't accept it easily. So I had to write small novels. People, I think people forgot me because I wrote in 1980 only. Then for 10 years I had started writing with a conviction that I'll create the path and that I'll create the bridge and I'll go back and I'll earn love. And against what? Against my service to the people, against my service that is giving voice or creating a voice for the voiceless who can't say. It is not the only human being. It is a tree, a river, anything who can't say that they are in pain, who can't say what they want. So to create that voice, I have them. Then I became mother. And that motherhood gave me a big meaning in my life, because motherhood means it is some kind of, you know, you become a part of the mother nature. You know, feeding a baby, carrying the baby inside, and the feeling of, you know, that I'm creating something, that's something I'm carrying inside alive, that gave me a different kind of feeling. And after that, in like from 1999, I started regularly, I started writing, and now I'm here in front of you, and I think and I believe that I have actually I have got the award that what I wanted, that is the love of my readers who believe in me. And so I feel thankful to my creator, and I feel happy when someone calls me midnight. Generally people, they don't call me, my readers, sometimes they call. When they say that I wanted to commit suicide, but I read your Maya Vitta, and I decided, no, I'm fine. Especially for Maya Vitta, I got many, you know, messages and calls from, especially from women, that they have, they earn or they derive that courage to face life. This is my journey. Now I'm seeing my end. So, I know that I don't have much time to create, you know. So I decided that I write my last novel, which generally, when I, just before my death, what I want to say to the people, what I have learned. I thought that I might not be able to write at the time. I might be very old, maybe ill. So I thought I should write first the last novel, then if I have time, then I will again write. So I don't know. There are a lot of people said, oh, we have decided kind of, so many questions came for people. But actually, this is my last novel. Maybe I'll again learn anything if I live more. Then again, maybe there may be a second part of my life. I don't know. But here, to conclude, but I want to tell you one thing about our Mitra Bayu. Actually, many readers, they, you know, I encourage reading my book. But I get encouraged when I see her. She doesn't know that. She doesn't know why. For her books, it is a totality. I always look at her, I read her on all, you know, her comments and all in social media. But I was just kind of, oh, I look at her, that from where she gets all this, you know, glow. And you don't know how she doesn't share her personal things. I know her because of Purvi Baido. I know because of Purvi, her friend Purvi Baido. So I know how, I don't know how she transformed darkness to light. I don't know. She's this beautiful lady. This beauty is, no, just comes from something. I don't have that. I don't have that. And I really, always I think about you. When I'm down, you don't know, by the, yeah, I never.